Hey guys, it's Board Prep Parents, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Primer, where last time I left off, I was supposed to play Arsenal twice, but the game changed it up on me and gave me and rescheduled a Merseyside derby into the last episode. So we had that instead. So interesting times in the last episode. I still won both matches, but, you know, I was expecting to have this match in the last episode. But, hey, what can you do? Not bothered in the least. I'm just pointing out that EA made me look like an idiot and a liar. And I don't appreciate that. Sturridge made the save. Corner now for Liverpool. Oh, come on, Sadio. For fuck's sake. What was that? Koscielny. Dude. Saw it coming. Cut it out. Good work. Nope. No one wants to get on the end of that except the dudes in the yellow shirts. No one in red wants to go on the end of that because they're apparently all fucking moronic at this point in time. They go through bouts of idiocy. Fortunately, they find a cure, then they get infected again. It's fucking stupid.
What a straightforward 2-0 win for them. And
oh yeah, just let yourself be muscled off the ball there, Nathaniel. Oh, that's not a problem at all. Seriously. Do I have to get a player, every fucking player, with 99 fucking strength? Because everyone gets fucking muscled off the ball just so easily. Just give the ball away, just not even under much of a challenge. And, you know, they're like, oh, here you go. Sorry, sir, I didn't realize that you were looking for the ball. Here you go. Just take it. Just fucking take it. I'm like, what the fuck? And I notice when I do that to the opposition, they apparently fucking have a whole team of Akinfenwas in disguise. Because apparently, I have to actually make a challenge or hope that they fuck up like Koscielny just did. Otherwise, it's stupidly hard to get the ball off of the opposition. Kieran Gibbs. And when I do tackle him, they get the ball back! Seriously, Firmino just tackled old Walcott and Gibbs for the ball. He got the ball from both of them on two separate occasions. He lost the ball back to them on both occasions. How does that work? Why? I don't know, you keep onto the ball? You know, that's a possibility. You know, that's an option. Fucking assholes. Out of play for a throw. What was that? That was AIDS. That was that. Well, it's a nice bit of skill, but the defending, well, it was woke to put them in front. Manny! You son of a whore. Header check, you son of a whore. He said that with his ribs. He didn't even say that with his hands, he said that with his ribs, him in the ribs. And like, oh yeah, that's safe. Soul! Ah! That would have been a great time for that to come off.
The home team with all the cards here, it seems. especially the points that they got for winning the away game on the ground of the opposition here. Well, if they play half as well as they did in that reverse game. A real chance here. Terrific stop.
Thank God Karius actually managed to save that. Oh, what a challenge, Alba. And of course, what? That I got the ball away. That was a good challenge. And you gave a free kick. You gave a free kick. And Denis Thompson, you fucking asshole. Fuck off. You whore. Remember, don't forget it. Referees are whores. All they do is take money from your opposition, fuck you, and you get nothing in return. Chelsea are winning. They're bringing Brighton. I'm not even surprised. Brighton are bottom of the table. Oh, Crystal Palace, at least they're looking like they're going to drop points. It's too bad I won't be able to take advantage at the moment because it is 0-0. No. I didn't score in the first half for the first game.
Working hard just to see maybe
I don't know when. I think the last one was that game against Sunderland last season. Stop.
And that will be a throw. Theo Walcott, Kieran Gibbs, Roberto Firmino, Sturridge,
Coutinho.
To switch on the attacking power in this.
The Hood avoids the challenge like a boss. Sadio Mane, there we go.
Position here, not picked up, and they paid a heavy price for that.
Sadio Mane, you fucking legend.
Well, the unpredictability of football, because no one would have called this really.
It took 11 minutes into the second half, but we finally broke Arsenal's defense down. We finally smashed through their fucking bus and scored 34 goals. I think that either levels him with last season or puts him one behind last season.
It's an Arsenal substitute who's getting ready. Attacking now, Danny Welbeck.
I know I wrote that down somewhere, this. That's from last season. Because I went back and watched the last episodes. I think they're on my phone. Hang on a sec.
Totally done the defender.
Comes in with this is stupidly dangerous. This looks get into a good position for me now. Come on. Someone make it into the box. Mane is there again. It's not even going to get anywhere near him.
It's big news, this, not just in Italy, all over Europe, all over the world, really. The new Juventus signing.
Staffy? Who I don't think... Oh, was he? Yeah, he was. This looks like Arsenal have did some dealings in the window. Arsenal fans will hope that's not the case. He's in real life that he pisses off after a season and a half. It's like, fuck off. It'd be like Dimitri Payet. Is it too soon?
Coutinho.
Yeah, to point out that everyone was right, that Dimitri Payet is in fact going to be leaving West Ham. Only a few months after everyone was predicting, he would leave in the summer, but he has chosen January for some reason. Why, I don't know.
Brilliant team play this,
What the hell did I write this stuff down? Hey! Good job. Fuck.
Might just withdraw him soon.
Well, now they're behind. Hell.
Try and switch things around. And here comes a substitution.
I wasn't paying attention. Who's Arsenal bring on there?
10 minutes left on the clock. It's going to go right to
a combo.
This one goal lead and the supporters.
Interesting choice. There's no question
about that. Just listen to them. Yeah, they've been brilliant.
Are you for real? Are you for real?
Keeping an eye on the time here. We still could have a decisive moment in the short time that remains. They've coped with it well defensively. He's got his shot off now.
Well, I would have been pissed because that would have taken away my 3 points. I would have held up my hands and said that was a good goal had it gone in. It would have been a good goal. Goal from Santi Cazorla. Try to give Arsenal a Christmas present, a late one, considering it's February.
Final whistle from the referee, Liverpool.
But that not to be the case.
Lloris Karius is the goalkeeper today. Sturridge, he's made the save.
No win, not my most convincing win, but hey, my Merseyside rivals did me a solid by beating Crystal Palace, which means they dropped more points. Fantastic.
Everton 2.
Convincingly puts them way down the ladder, though. Doesn't it?
1. West Ham United 3, Swansea City 2, Manchester City 1.
Do some training.
1, Bournemouth 1. Now let's see what effect that's had on the league standings. At the top of the
let's get Moya in to get up to 66th rated.
In third, Manchester United with 45 points. In fourth, Arsenal with 41 points, with a game in hand on the team above. In fifth, Crystal Palace with 40
points. Wait, what happened to Firmino? In sixth, Leicester City. Hello?
In seventh, Newcastle United.
You're welcome.
Game in hand on the team above. In eighth, rising up the table are Everton with 32 points. Bottom of the table, Brighton and Hove Albion with 6 points.
Prize money before the game against Barra. An international job for France. Yeah, I don't want that at all. I can't find where I put this down. You know what's weird? Burrow was my last match last season. The last game of the league season. Before I played the Champions League final, the FA Cup final against, I think, was it Manchester United? Or was it Manchester City? I don't know who it was.
Manchester City discuss. It's not been what they've delivered in recent years, particularly since they got greater financial backing. And those owners would be a bit worried about what's going on so far this season.
I can't remember that, but I can remember for where the last game.
I just don't think they're going to recover.
Much earlier for taking them on for the second time this season. Here we are. 35 he scored last season, so he's one off of it.
Attacker in the lineup. This is the Liverpool side. Lloris Carrier.
Interesting. So he's two goals away from.
Central midfield in attack. Daniel Sturridge starts.
He's breaking his own record of 35 goals last season.
Could be dangerous.
Is it 35 or is it 34? Is the record of is there Henri or Van Nistelrooy? Might as well look that up while I'm here. See if I already broke that record or obviously. It's not the highest that has ever been scored in a career move by me. Of course, that was at Cristiano Ronaldo with that 40 plus. Although, Mane still has time. We're only in early February. This is only the second game in February. So, still good few games to get for him to get to break 40. Like I said, in the last FIFA, Ronaldo was the only player, and I've had players score 30 plus goals in FIFA's plenty of time.
Trying to stretch the opposition.
Only Ronaldo has ever broken 40 goals.
Away, trying to find room for a shot, maybe.
And it is a real surprise to me that he didn't break 50, especially in that second season. I thought he was going to break 50 in about 5 minutes. He was scoring for fun. Like, it looked a lot easier than in his first season at the club. He only got two seasons before the game was obsolete and had to be deleted in favor of FIFA 17.
Yeah, nice and tight at the back in the 1-0 win. Clean sheets are great, and the strikers can score. I think they will win today again.
New club for Alexis Sanchez. He has joined Bayern Munich.
Yeah, he's coming for decent money, about £30 million. That's what I've been reading anyway, so he'll have to do that figure justice.
Here, the challenge is a good one. A little private game between the two of them. Gaston Ramirez into the attacking third.
Okay, for fuck's sake, I get it. You can pass it around, bunch of fucking ping pong bastards.
Slide challenge, but it's definitely a foul.
Well, he's dived in. It's a reckless one.
No, that's showing me something else. Showing me the players with the most goals in the Premier League history. Me. All right, no, that's Alan Shearer. It's not what I want.
Tried to tackle here, and he's done that. He's tackled well. It was a good challenge. It's led to a corner. So we can see again the effort from Gaston Ramirez.
Yeah, so far out. Yeah, he's gone for the side foot, and the ball just climbing a little bit too much, hitting the bar.
Most goals in a 38-game season, 31. Huh. It's only 31? I always thought it was like 34 or something like that. It's 31. Joint holders is Alan Shearer, Cristiano Ronaldo, and Luis Suarez. Shearer for Blackburn. Ronaldo, of course, for Manchester United, and Suarez, of course, for Liverpool. Huh. So, if Suarez had scored one more goal in that season, he would have been the top goal scorer. He would have scored the most goals in Premier League in one Premier League season in the history of the I thought Thierry Henry and Van Nistelrooy scored 34. I guess one of them scored 34. Can I imagine that? Or maybe I was thinking of a FIFA. Maybe. I mean, I'm not gonna lie. I often signed either Henry or Van Nistelrooy in my earlier FIFA days. Normally it would be Henry though. This was before he had cheated, and I hate his guts forever. I want him off my fucking TV every time I fucking see it, cunt. Seriously, who this guy thought it would be a good idea? Oh, let's give this guy a fucking job, because the Irish fans will fucking love that. They won't want every waking minute to see he want to spill his French blood all over that studio. No, that would be fucking stupid. Why would they want to do that? So Sadio Mane has already broken the record. So he's now chasing his own record of 35 goals. Now the other teams are playing. Well, none of the other teams in relation to me. That'd be Manchester United, Chelsea, Arsenal. I kind of want to say Crystal Palace. With that recent loss to Everton, they're almost out of it. Well, no one's in it. There is no race. It doesn't exist. It is coming to a merciful end soon. Don't worry about that.
He's missed it by a mile. I just cannot believe.
Excuse me.
Good position here, and he could get away here. And here's the shot. Oh, great work by the keeper. Roberto Firmino, and he's up for the header.
Oh, Sadio Mane, he is chasing that record now. Oh, well, I'm chasing that record now. Well, it's like a carrot. It's something to go for because the league is all but one. If the game had any sense, it would give me the league title. Now it would declare me champion now because. This race is pathetic and over. It's been over since, well, November, pretty much. Seriously, it was over weeks in.
Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation.
Coutinho, off the post, Mane equals the record. And now he's only one goal away from breaking his own record. Back-to-back 35 goal seasons for Sadio Mane. That's 70 goals. That is 70 league goals in two seasons for Sadio Mane. Now, if he keeps this up, Mane is young. If he keeps this up, he's going to fucking chase down Ian Rush. Slowly but surely, you know, he have to play for us for 10 in seasons to keep getting 30 goals a season. That'll get him up to 300 pretty quick.
Now we've got it.
Maybe he'll break 40. Who knows? He is only 5 goals away from it. Those are two little goals that Sadio Mane can set himself. One, can he break his own 35 goals in a season record from last season?
Did that well, intercepted.
And two, can he become only the second player to...
That is the equalizing goal.
Fuck's sake. Can he become only the second player to score 40 plus goals? Or 40 goals at all. Like, the only other person to get near it was, we've had a few players get to 39. Like, I'm not even joking. On FIFA 12, oh, Suarez got to 39. I had a penalty in the last game. I just said, Suarez is taking this. He could get to 40. I hit the post. The keeper. The ball comes to the keeper. He spills it. And it's going in. It's slowly rolling in. And freaking the defender comes from out of fucking nowhere and fucking lashes it as hard as he could down the pitch. I was like, what the fuck? Where did that dude come from? I was looking at the ball. I wasn't paying any attention to what was going on around me. And he didn't get another chance because shortly after that, he got entangled in a scrap with a player. You know, one of those situations where, you know, they're broken, hang up, scrambling for the ball. On the one of them ends up fucking injured. You know, any of you who play Ultimate Team, you will see it a million times. Because it always seems to happen on Ultimate Team, but sometimes happens on career mode as well.
They gave it straight to him, didn't they? Well, this attack has been a menace to it. And here's the shot. How much difference that could have made.
I never touched the sliders, but if I did, the only one I would touch is the injury ones. You know, the ones that, you know, determine severity and frequency.
Sturridge, great stop, punched away by the goalkeeper.
I did, you know, have a look at those one year, a few years ago. Oh, in FIFA, when the game was dead, I said, you know, let's have a look at what the game is like with sliders. So I, you know, messed with the sliders and just, you know, play a few games just to see how different it was. Because the injury ones fuck up the game royally. I mean, royally fuck it up. Because, you know, if you... Oh, even...
Well, given their status in the match...
I put frickin' injury frequency up high on the computer, thinking, oh, the player just might get hurt. And, you know, they use up their substitutions early. Almost every fucking little touch and... the opposition player went down fucking injured. I'm like, are you freaking kidding me? What's the point of this? What is the actual point of it? And stuff like that is why I don't use sliders. It's despite what people believe. Some people... are such idiots. They actually believe I use sliders. Even though if you... I've shown you on numerous times I don't.
At the top of the table remain Liverpool with 75 points. In second,
I don't know what else I can do. You just don't want... Some people just don't want to accept how good at this game I am. And that's sad. Because they're losers who can't beat the computer and they're saying, oh, the computer... I can't play against the computer, I'm better against opposition online. I don't know why I'm putting it like surfer dude fucking accent, but... Yo, you get my point. These idiots who say, oh, the computer's too hard to beat, I can't beat it. A fucking real life person is probably harder to beat. Because they're unpredictable. You can kind of predict stuff that the fucking computer might do. Who?
With 19 points.
What fucking?
West Ham United with 26 points, but only behind on goal difference. Fifth bottom, climbing the table are...
Try and predict what a real-life person will do. Oh, like, the comp- Pierre will never, ever change formation. They'll never make logical substitutions. The computer always makes idiotic substitutions. You know, bringing on key players when they're 4-0 down in the 80-something minute. You don't know how you've seen that happen dozens of times. I'm like, what is the freaking point of bringing that player on now? What's he gonna do? You've already lost. You've already lost. What is the point? So, to the people who say that they can't play against the computer, don't bullshit me. Don't bullshit me, because, you know, when you bullshit me, you're bullshitting yourself, because I don't believe a fucking word you say. I could beat any team. With any team. On Legendary. Against the computer. Blindfolded. But online, I have a difficult time because I can't. I don't know the player. I don't know who I'm up against. I don't know how they play. But if I knew you and, you know, we played regularly, I'd fucking whip your ass. But that's... Online is harder. Let's just put that to rest. Online is harder. So, anyone who tells you fucking air mode sucks because the computer is, you don't like playing against the computer, you're a fucking asshole and you're a bullshitter. Because you're just making excuses that, you might be good against, you might be okay or good or whatever on Ultimate Team, but on the game, in career mode, the mode that made this game, for which, if not for career mode, FIFA would have died and you would have no Ultimate Team. So, thank you very much. You are fucking welcome. If not for career mode, you would have no Ultimate Team, because if not for career mode, FIFA would be dead. If you can't beat the computer, then you are not a true player. You're not a true FIFA YouTuber. Or FIFA player. If you're not on YouTube. If you can't beat the computer. So, if you specifically play online, I want you to, when you stop watching this video, go onto your PlayStation or Xbox, whichever console you're on. Play 10 games against the computer on whatever difficulty you can. Maybe play one game on each difficulty, and then if at a point you lose or draw, then play a few games on that difficulty until you master it. That's how it works. And that will enable you to get better at the game and for you to stop fucking complaining. You little bitches. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.